The Honorable Linda Thompson, who is the mayor of Harrisburg. She was sworn in as Harrisburg's 33rd mayor on January 4th, 2010, and she took office as the first African-American and first female mayor of this city. We're delighted to welcome her. This is now her third time coming to our convention, and we ask her to welcome us and share her remarks.
Assalamu alaikum. May peace be upon you. May God's blessing be upon you. May God's blessing be upon you, your good works. On behalf of the citizens of this great city, I welcome you with peace and respect to our beautiful city. We are grateful for your presence and the peaceful message of Islam. The true meaning of Islam and community service that has been sustained throughout the long history of Islamic thinking. May peace and blessings be upon his good works and profound teachings. I am pleased that you have again chosen our beautiful city, our beautiful community, as an appropriate gathering place. We are excited for you to be here for Jalsa, Salana 2013, the 65th annual convention of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community. May God's blessings be upon all of you. Harrisburg, the state capital of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, has a rich history of diversity. We are a people committed to fundamental human rights of equality for all, freedom of speech, and freedom of religion that stems back as far as the American Revolution. Our city joins you in the commitment to global peace, advocacy for universal human rights, especially for those who are the least among us, protections for minorities, religious freedoms for all, and championing the empowerment of education of women. These are great and noble undertakings. I fully appreciate and share your belief in these fundamental human principles, which are shared by all of the great religions of the world, as well as those who choose no religion practice. In light of the recent events of the last weeks in terms of violence in our community and nation, federal court decisions and political events regarding equality in America, it is so fitting that the theme for your gathering this year celebrates the life and teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, message of peace, with a focus on three critical areas from his farewell address: sanctity of life, property and honor, the rights of women, and equality. Peace and service are the aspirations of all peoples of the world. In today's world, where there is so much violence, it is so important for us to remember these principles and incorporate them in our daily lives. Like the Prophet Muhammad, we respect the sanctity of life, property, and honor. We concur with his thoughts that your lives and your possessions have been made immune by God to attacks by one another until the judgment day. We hear the echo of Prophet Muhammad's words that it is unjust to take any man's life or his property or attack his honor. It is unjust to take any man's life or his property or attack his honor. These words we must repeat again and again. It is our community so that the trend of violence against one another will stop. We must end the violence. The focus of the rights of women, powerful. The focus of rights for women, powerful. I recently spoke at a women's empowerment conference and talked about how important it is for women to be empowered physically, mentally, financially, educationally, and spiritually, and any other way we need to be empowered, and then help other women be empowered. Sometimes women need to get refueled or fueled, empowered in general, as daughters, mothers, wives. So many of us get so caught up into taking care of others that we sometimes don't focus on our own needs, who we are, what we are, and our own self-value. We know that women are the first teachers of our children. We know that the hand that rocks the cradle rocks the world. And we know that a woman who knows her own worth, her rights and responsibilities, an empowered woman, is a woman who can be strong, can be a strong teacher, partner in life, and influence on the next generation. How powerful then the words of Prophet Muhammad as he speaks to the issue of rights of women and how they should be treated. We hear his words, O men, who have some rights against your wives, but your wives are also some rights against you. He said, remember, you must always treat your wives well. God has charged you with the duty of looking after her. How true still today the words of the Prophet. When you married, God appointed you the trustees of those rights. You brought your wives to your homes under the law of God. You must not, therefore, insult the trust which God has placed in your hands. The trust is required from both sides. It is so important that we all continue to demonstrate respectful, responsible, and appropriate behavior so that our children and generations to come will learn to live in the same peaceful and trust manner society. Finally, how wise the words of the Prophet Muhammad as he addressed the issue of equality simply yet profoundly. It is ironic, yet prophetic, that as your conference focuses on equality this weekend, immediately preceding Independence Day, the Freedom Jubilee will be held tomorrow in downtown Harrisburg to celebrate the ribbon cutting of the Bethel Heritage Trail that honors the contributions of African Americans, equals in the struggle for freedom and independence in America. All the great religions of the earth recognize that through an empathetic understanding of our common human experience and existence, we will discover ourselves in the self of the other, and thereby create an appropriate human context for peace and equality. As the Prophet Muhammad said, all Muslims are as brethren to one another. All of you are equal. He went on to say, even as the fingers of two hands are equal, so are human beings equal to one another. No one has any right, any superiority to claim over another. You are as brothers. Peace and equity are the natural state of all humanity. We all aspire to peace regardless of race or religious orientation. The gift of human life is extremely sacred. We all deserve to live in peace and be treated fairly, equitably, and with respect regardless of race, creed, sex, religion, age, disability, political belief, or any other characteristic, because they are our God-given rights. The Quran teaches us peace is essential to the future of our planet. We cannot advance to the highest levels of technology and science without a firm foundation in the service of humanity, especially service to those in the world who are in need of education as well as economic and social justice. It is the rich tradition and wisdom of the Ahmadiyya community that teaches us not to take up the sword, but to spread peace through the individual beauties of Ahmadiyya faith. To attract others, especially and peacefully, through one's exemplary behavior. Your community teaches a commitment to modernize Islam through education, moderation, and restraint. You are a bridge to the great faiths of the world in these often turbulent times. We thank you, and we appreciate you for continuing to focus light issues on our humanity. Therefore, on behalf of the citizens of this great capital city, I take great pride in welcoming His Holiness, Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed, and the 2013 Jalsa Salana to the peaceful city of Harrisburg. May God bless you and bring you peace. May God bless you and the good works of the Ahmadiyya community. Assalamu alaikum. God bless you.